Level.
And in both of those encounters, Xu Xin won 4-0.
Love one.
Comfortably on the receive, Xu Xin not pulling out the big weaponry just yet. Wrist taped up. Chop block sits shallow on the table, a little bit high, but very difficult to play. We saw chop blocks like this yesterday. Attempted anyway. Catching the ball when it's already on its way down, it's a tough ball to play. Two chop blocks in a row, and this time it's the side spin that overpowers, carrying Liam Pitchford's touch shot wide. And no chop block needed here. Spinny opening attack. 4 points to love from the start here for Xu Xin. Now remember when the wrist injury came. Say World Tour Grand Finals in Zhengzhou, relatively early in the tournament. A little break off the net here for Xu Xin. Second bounce on the table. Think about how precise, how aware Xu Xin has to be of his space to play the ball on the table immediately following a second bounce. He didn't hit the table. Even though he lost the point, that's really quite incredible control and awareness. Dangerous. That's how I would describe Liam Pitchford's game. An inside-out forehand from down low. That's the type of risk he's going to have to take. A slow start, but two quick points after the 0-5. There's the backhand. Speedy and out in front. Plays that ball with a lot of forward motion. Not easy to do. Tough to rally with Xu Xin. As I've described many times before, God, gotta love that replay of the backhand of Pitch from inside the table, though. That first backhand is so quick. Rallying with Xu Xin is tough because every ball's a little bit different. His spin variation.
3-6.
And still calm and focused right now, Xu Xin in the touch game. Xu Xin actually slowing down the opponent eventually. Liam Pitchford in for the counters with the speed early on. I think his first two big counters. Watch one more time. One. Where's the pace? Covers the middle with the forehand. The backhand, so much wrist on that ball. Second forehand, also some pace, but then Xu Xin turns it up a notch.
8-3.
Liam Pitchford is in a very exclusive club as the threat to the Chinese. Not just Ma Long that he's beat, Zhou Qihao, Shuai Fei. But of the biggest names, Fan Zhendong, Xu Xin, Ma Long. Ma Long is the only one that he's taken down, at least as far as I could find on ITTF.com. So a handful of recent victories over Chinese opponents, but not yet a game against Xu Xin. Right up near the camera, I'd love to see that ball hit the lens just for sake of cool perspective or the rareness of that. Serve barely drifting long, and Xu Xin around the corner, so comfortable, plays the short side on the next ball, and has 7 game points.
11,
soft and spinny, 11-3. Vladi Samsonov, earlier on in this tournament. Good placement, a little bit more central on the table. Pitch, instead of going to the backhand. We saw this from Wang Chuqin against Fan Zhendong, sometimes playing the middle of the table. Doesn't have to be the most powerful shot, just subtle changes to make the opponent backpedal.
One more.
Now if I'm Gavin Evans, I'm in the corner shaking my head, yes, this is right. Missing the shot, okay. Making the right decisions, that's the important thing here. Perfect placement on the opening attack right into the body. Anything that Liam Pitchford can do to get Shushin behind the table. Still, he's dangerous from there, but a bit more controllable.
Let. 2, 1.
Oh, man.
2-0.
We've got two behind-the-back specialists out here, but this one goes way deep to the corner. How fast Shushin is to spring on this opportunity. He's waiting. Says, you know what, I hit a ball to a place that I don't think Pitch is going to be able to keep short. Sorry. Almost saves it.
2-3.
Bit of fortune here for Liam Pitchford to go up by one. Now, watching Shushin play this match reminds me of why players who are so strong like Lin Winru, the silent assassin, and Tomokazu Harimoto have not yet beaten Shushin. And a big part of that is, from right behind the table, he can still spin the ball.
3-0.
Most players get uncomfortable when the ball's so close to the side of the table or the back edge of the table. But Shushin can navigate that in a way, just like the end of game number one. There were two balls that were very uncomfortable for most to play, and Shushin just slows down the racket, says, I'll play it shallow.
Let.
Sort of three, like I was talking four. About with Fang Zhendong versus Wang Chuqin.
Let. 3-0. Four.
So I brought up Vlady Samsonov as the defeater of world number four, Lin Gaoyuan. The player to beat Vlady Samsonov was Liam Pitchford, 4-2.
Three, five.
A bit more fortune. Right now, Pitch collecting his points. And Shushin harvesting his IOUs, saving up for a rainy day. A bit unusual. We see this in more exhibition point moments from Shushin when he's up 10-2 in the fourth, 3-0. The ball just sits a little bit too high, and even though it's baseline, Pitch comes through with the power.
Six, four.
That's the rotation. The heavy spin shot, slow and spinny from Shushin. When he goes for the drive for the kill shot, he's got so much power. But when he wants to slow it down, that change of pace, he's in control.
Six, five.
The flexible wrist. The brushing ice cream cone flick does not come down. Just a bit under the ball.
Go.
Five, not to say that seven. The under the ball, more so to modify the ice cream cone flick, but that brushing shot with under and side spin can be a very effective shot, and we've seen Pitch make it many times. But there's a different look right now, a bit of determination. Scoreboard as well. Pitch leading 7-5.
Go.
Side of the table here.
Eight.
Shushin's chop block. Throughout, Pitch was grunting and pounding the ball as hard as a player as tall as he is could, time and time again. Look how inside out that ball was. So much side spin in the Cloud Walkers there. Omnipresent Shushin. He's just run enough to get your exercise for an entire match in 1 point. Sky lobs, backhands, and everything else. The replay continues. Point of the day, have we just witnessed that? Right at the baseline, incredible play. That is heartbreaking. Liam Pitchford is up. I mean, for Liam Pitchford. Of course, for Xu Xin, it's just the opposite. Chinese fans, it's hard to warm up. A big point here, though. Pitch has never taken a game, not a single game in his history against Xu Xin. So to be up 8-5, it's a big opportunity. It's part of the reason we see such determination and focus right now from Pitch. And now three game points for Liam Pitchford to do what he's never done before. Liu Guoliang style serve. The chop block, and he kills the next ball. Liam Pitchford back for game number three. Pitch to start. That forward motion, Xu Xin doing an excellent job to catch this ball while it's high. That's a very difficult ball to play otherwise. Soft and spinny. And finally, a backhand that misses. Again, the apology, a little fortune to change the pace here. Look at the hook on that ball, side and topspin. Xu Xin's face, man, come on. This is I don't want to get any more IOUs right now. I just want to get some points out here.
2-1.
Well protected on the serve, shuts down. The opening flick here from Pitch. Making his adjustments on the receive. Smart placement, a very shallow touch shot behind the net. Xu Xin handles it well, and he plays inside out pitch right into the body, across the chest. Man, when Pitch is able to play shots like this, it's just incredible. And I thought we were gonna have another moment with the Xu Xin show. Again, that point in game number two at 5-8 might not only have been point of the day. If people remember it at the end of 2020, it could be nominated for point of the year. The ITTF Star Award's still a long way away. So despite being beaten 11-3 in game number one, Pitch comes back to do something he's never done before and win a game. He wins game number two. He was in the lead here, but tied up at the first towel break right now. This is the job of the athlete, knowing that you've never taken a game off the opponent, to come to the table knowing that it's possible for you to win.
Two, three, four.
Like, really, that belief that if I do things right, today is the day. The players that Liam Pitchford has beaten to get here, he's in outstanding form, no question about it. But again, a bit of side spin in that variation, combinations of side and top spin from Xu Xin in the attacking game, make him tough to work with. See the bend on that ball, even with the turned racket. Maybe especially with the turned racket, it's quite difficult, but Pitch trying to work with the side spin. And another one.
Four.
Edge of the table, a bit more fortune for Pitch. Now, I mentioned Pitch is having an outstanding tournament. Thinking back to Bulgaria 2018, his win over Malone. Not to take away from that incredible victory, but there were some issues on service. Ma Long was called on service a few times in that match. It was a seven gamer. Short side of the table, Pitch straightens it out a bit. Again, that flexibility. He's able to be so agile in the wrist. One block, he just fans up, turns the racket inside out. 2-point lead for Pitch on the receive. on the move. Quick cover, his timing. He's doing a lot of work right now to take the ball earlier than usual. This is a big part of Pitch's threat for me. One of the many reasons that everyone who's faced him hasn't been able to take him down, despite a player who beat Tomokazu Harimoto in this tournament. One of the IOUs cashed in. A bit of fortune back for Shushin. All right. Hello. Good to see you. It's funny, there's Liu Wei Shan. And then there's Liu Fei, the chopper. Need to see more of them both on the world tour.
Seven, six.
So I've told you about who. No, I haven't told you who Shushin beat to get here. Start with him, Frane Kojic. From the Croatian team, made it all the way to the main draw, but 4-1, I remember when he won that one game. He made it quite memorable with a giant chole. Shushin wins that 4-1. Enjoy the replay here. Again, the timing to stay so close. Liam Pitchford's taller than most. Shushin is as well in terms of his teammates. The pitch, I'd say, probably a good 6'2". What's that, a good 187 or so, maybe?
7-8.
I bring that up because standing so tall, he finds ways to play the ball low. While the ball's still low, out in front, quick timing. It's part of his dangerous game, but right now, the danger factor is Shushin is within one, and the Liu Guoliang serve comes back. Good net recovery here. Pitch hangs in there. It might look easy, and especially in a slightly slower net ball. That one right there, but pitch stays near the table, keeps his timing in the rally, or at least makes his adjustments. This is tough in these rallies. Looking for the first attack. Doing what he can to take the flick well. Flick not bad, but not enough to really cause trouble for Shushin in this rally. Ooh, good push from Shushin. Wouldn't be the first time we saw someone have a bit of issue with the flooring or the movement here. The Cloud Walker. Very delicate in the feet, is able to reach everything. You saw it in the second game. It's 2 game points here for Liam Pitchford, a player who's never taken one game before today. 2 game points to take his second game. For me, this is the right decision. Well spun by Shushin, and Pitch has to go for it. And the conversation for me is really much more interesting talking about it from Pitch's point of view. After all, Shushin, the strong favorite, had never lost a game before today. Pitch plays that perfectly. Players back for game number 4, the Cloudwalker, Shushin with the serves.
One love.
If I sound like I'm talking quietly at times, a handful of reasons for that. I've seen Shushin giving looks up here, and whether it's the local commentator sitting next to me or myself, I want to make sure I'm not interfering with the game.
Love to.
Quality start here from Shushin. Taking the first 2 points, down 1-2 in games.
Love three.
Interesting to see something we saw from Fang Zhendong also earlier against Wang Chuqin, playing patiently inside the table, tempting the opponent, forcing the opponent to play the short game. Oh, perfect shot, right on the white of the line. Shushin not dropping a point yet. It's a confident trot around the court. gets the block from behind the table. That's how powerful the shot is. Even with pitch about 10 feet behind the table, it's still somewhere between a block and a fishing shot, not just straight up fishing. Chop block goes wide. Now starting off the match, two of the first 3 points for Shusheen were chop blocks. You might recall that. The side spin, Liam Pitchford has made his adjustments though. First point for pitch this game. Perfect combination. A fast flick right to the corner. And I use the word perfect a lot lately, in the last few points, but that's what it feels like. Pitch has to play. The level of play from both players is so high right now. Two shots in a row, corner to corner. Shusheen gets the first one, no problem, but the timing for the second one, just too much work to do. Smiles in the crowd. I know fans on YouTube would kill to be here watching this live. Shallow and low, this fishing shot. Not an easy ball to play. Pitch tries to spin it a little bit slowly on that last one. Actually, it looked a little bit more like a drive in that replay. Chop block comes long and pitch back within two. It's tough when you've got someone, just to comment on the point before, when you've got someone fishing and it's low to the net and shallow, it's tough to slow your game down, to really spin the ball softly. Ooh, one IOU cashed in. I still think Shusheen's probably got a good 4 or 5 left. Good cover there with the racket head straight up in the middle. Change of heart, and it catches Shusheen leaning back. This is the type of combination play Liam Pitchford's gonna have to continue playing. He's been doing it so well so far. One right into the body, gets his opponent leaning, and then follows up by moving in and taking the ball right off the bounce.
4-7.
And this one gets away a bit. You can see it from the facial expression. Not an easy ball. But for Liam Pitchford's standards so far in this match, the way he's been playing, it's one that he has to convert. Just like Shusheen had before. Done to him. Fast ball into the body. In a moment where maybe he expected one more soft touch shot. So from 3-5, but from 5-3, Shusheen has pulled ahead to a 4-point lead, serves on his side.
Let 8-4. Nine-4.
Good placement here on the parallel. Shusheen from behind the table causing some trouble. Really just free with that backhand.
Five,
the chop block comes down, curving and sailing as pitch drives it deep to the backhand. Just thinking about, in this match so far, on the attack, how many shots can you think of that Shusheen has missed with his backhand?
Let 5-9. Let
2019, Shusheen five, became quite dominant nine. Over the summer.
Six,
good play
nine.
Into the middle. It's not just the placement of this shot. It's the concern that Shusheen has that Liam Pitchford could go deep to the corners at any moment. It's that unpredictability, the danger factor of pitch that makes the middle so effective. Oh, countered back as beautifully as can be. The backhand we were talking about. The backhand that used to be something that Shusheen was afraid to play. He's got the confidence and consistency here. Hits a winner past on the length of the table. The snap of the backhand to generate that much power. in such a short stroke. Only one game point needed. Alongside Wang Chuqin, who you just saw earlier in the first televised match of the day. Good bending backhand here. This is something we see a lot from Mima Ito. Liam Pitchford using that wrist and flexibility very well. Look how closed the angle of the racket. I don't think closed is the perfect term, turned. He has to make such perfect contact to really keep the ball in play as low as he did with the side spin. Chuqin right back in it though. 1 point apiece. Now tactically this is smart, a fast long serve into the middle. Taller players have a bigger midsection and they tend to use the backhand to cover that middle section. So suddenly when you're targeting the middle, you just move it a little bit more to the forehand side of the elbow.
Leg. 2-1.
Touch, shallow shot to the forehand side. Chuqin looking down at his equipment. I've seen him in that. I'd say it's quite common, no tell. Oh, beautiful counter. A little bit off the edge of the racket, I believe. The sound, hence the apology from Chuqin, but his backhand is on point, earns him this point. So dangerous. Pitch plays the ball well. Now this is a WWMLD. What would Ma Long do? And I think Ma Long would spin that ball softly to the forehand side. This one right here. He knows Chuqin would be waiting on the backhand corner. Pitch makes a quality shot, but still with Chuqin there, it's tough. He's got to keep it out of his comfort zone.
Four, three.
Good opening backhand here, that backhand from Liam Pitchford. Again, there are a handful of backhands outside of the Chinese national team that are talked about. Liam Pitchford's one of the most talked about in the game, alongside Tomokazu Hatemoto.
Two. Four. Oh.
Interesting. Is that a premature cho from Chuqin? I don't know what happened. It sounded like a choke from Liam Pitchford. It sounded like Pitch's choke. I don't know if something hit the shirt. The point was stopped. See if we can find out later. That's a Chuqin Chole. Still thinking about that point before. Again, from this camera angle down low, we have a little bit more clear vision of what's going on. More spatial awareness from up high. Better sense of the player's movement around the court. Ah, smart play. Very patient, Liam Pitchford. Waits till the last moment, and you just can't tell where he's gonna go. He waits to see that Chuqin makes his move to the backhand corner. Doesn't go for a kill shot, just spins it the other way, still generates enough pace and spin. Gotta love that calm look from Chuqin. I wonder if we will see Chuqin in the coach's corner at some point, as a coach. And again, there's a calm right now. Liam Pitchford not trying to kill the first ball, simply earn himself a good first ball to kill. Meaning, earn himself a good opportunity to really just play to win the point. And that was the shot. Could see the difference. The snap that he puts into that last ball after the more controlled opening shots. So tied up at 6 points apiece now. Pitch with the serves. What a shot! The placement here from Pitch. Xu Xin just making this ball skid back on the table. Is it over the net? Yeah, it is, but it's right to the corner on the run. Nearly perfection once again from Xu Xin. And to be able to hold up the shot like that, the showman, this is not for show. This is absolutely practical play here, and it makes it so tough for Pitch. Pitch played a softball inside the table that looked unattackable. Xu Xin using his penhold grip and his years of experience to win that point. Oh my goodness! The bend on the ball, the quality of shots in this rally. The chop block that Xu Xin brought back right there touched perfectly. And then the heavy spin ball. How do you attack it like this? Liam Pitchford, that's magic. This is a shot that if you miss the shot, a coach says, what are you doing to even take it? And Pitch makes it. And trying to play the control against Xu Xin in this rally. Not easy to do with any consistency. That being said, Pitch has done it with incredible consistency. But a human and forgivable moment there. Xu Xin, well-earned point. And finally, a ball out of reach. He still gets a racket on it, the Cloud Walker. I guess that's what omnipresence is all about. The only occasion we see it from Xu Xin is if he turns the corner. A double pump here, a moment of hesitation, but it pays off, that change of heart. Pitch just calculating the risks with a relatively short stroke. Gets a bit of racket speed and spins the ball. 9 points apiece at the third towel break. Still a long way to go for Pitch and something that he's never done before. But going up 3-2 would make that belief very much a reality for Pitch. The bend on the ball and the forehand from Pitch. It's a fine balance for him from behind the table, but he refuses to back up even more. As close as he can stay, just enough to keep the angle, leaning way forward using that lengthy reach. And the inside-out forehand there. Xu Xin might have been tempted to try and step around, and the danger factor high. It's game point for Pitch. And similar to the WWMLD situation, what would Ma Long do earlier? Pitch plays it deep to the backhand corner. A little bit safer in quotes, but Xu Xin waiting there. Saves game point. Deuce in game number 5. And the backhand spin shot, a race to that backhand corner. Xu Xin able to secure the point. Considering some of the shots that have been made out here, Pitch definitely would have liked to have had that one. What a bad opportunity, but the point probably would have continued even had he made it. Game point for Xu Xin. Smart play. He'd gone out wide to the forehand many times. He's got Xu Xin frozen up a bit, trying to figure out where the ball's gonna go. He takes one hop to the forehand side. Xu Xin just to cover because he'd been burned there on the wide forehand a few points in a row. The touch inside the table shuts down Xu Xin's attack. That ball has to be so low. Think about the times you've seen Xu Xin attack from inside the table. That's as low to the net as a serve, and it stays inside the table, 1 point away. Game point Pitch. Up. Trying taking the backhand, goes for the Chiquita. Side and topspin. Very difficult to receive, Shushin, in the service game. Fourth towel break, the only score line possible. Having talked to the silent assassin about receiving Shushin's serves, he said they're so difficult. Quality flick with the forehand, another game point for Pitch. No timeout here. Again, it's pretty much the only occasion I see a timeout when someone has won a point and they've had trouble in the receive game in deuce. The pitch has been quite clever. No shortage of ideas out here under pressure. He changes it up. Gotta hand it to him for trying something different. Long push to the backhand corner. Shushin handles well, pumps himself up. Shushin had his moment before the summer. It was the World Championships where Simon Gauzy got the best of him. And after that, seemed to have this deep motivation. This unstoppable drive.
Go!
And a spinny backhand to the short side of the table. Another game point for Liam Pitchford.
Time out.
Let's see if those words of wisdom, brilliance, really come into play here. Short game does it. It's the follow-up. As much as I can pick up from other languages, it's really not even comparable to listening to that timeout.
Go! Last one.
The difference between a guessing game and hearing every word that was said for the most part. So Pitch continuing here on the receive. Ooh, this one gets away. A little bit of fortune early in the point. But you know what? He's got to keep the risk up, just like this. For me, he takes the right shot. There was the one off the net. And even missing that shot, he's playing right.
One, two.
Now the funny thing is, I think it's fair to say Shushin is my favorite player in the game. It's just interesting to see upsets in general. That bendy wrist again from Liam Pitchford. Who would have thought coming into this match that we would be in game number 6? And if we ever got to game number 6, Liam Pitchford would be the one in the lead. You saw as much as I did there. Shushin up by one. That was a very tough serve to receive. Ball comes a little bit clear of the table. Normally, Shushin will convert this point. Relatively good placement, though, considering how difficult of a position Liam Pitchford was in on that receive. Use of side and top from Pitch. The banana flick from inside the table.
Timeout.
Here it is. I was thinking, when are we going to see it? It was similar to the experience of hearing the English boys talk. A little bit behind the table. Heavy spin here from Shushin. It's a big part of his game. The rotation factor is incredibly high. So 4 points apiece, tied up. First point out of the timeout for Shushin.
Five,
good pressure
four.
From baseline at the table. Now in terms of calculating risks, not having to win the ball or win the point on the first ball, similar for Shushin. He's got incredible feeling. He can change the pace. He's good in the short game. The bendy forehand comes out again. Think about relative to Liam Pitchford's height, where he's playing this ball. The racket never even comes above the shoulder. At highest, the tip of the racket at shoulder height. That's a very uncomfortable ball. Elbow down. That point was just spectacular. Shushin had so much work to do from the wide forehand where he hits it really wide on the counter. This one right here across the chest. Shushin lunges in to play it. That was the most impressive ball to me. Already gets the racket up in traditional penhold backhand. And then turns to play the forehand for the win.
Six off.
We've seen some incredible matches this tournament. And unless you saw the highlights video where we're watching the live stream of Ma Long versus Wang Chuqin, I personally still haven't had the opportunity to see that match. But see, Meng Gouzi versus Shuxin was just incredibly high-level play. Every match I've seen from Liam Pitchford as well. And the softer, spinnier one doesn't go for the kill. There's almost no higher compliment in table tennis than bringing up Waldner and comparing anything you do to him. But Waldner, a master at doing what Pitch just did. And if that ball curves back on, there's a real chance here. Good save by Pitch for a moment. Few can lob down Shuxin. Good save here off the top edge of the racket, stays in play. And 2 points in a row, big adjustments from Shuxin. The point before this, Pitch spun slowly, a little bit more shallow. The way I was talking about Waldner, the way Waldner used to do. An attempting serve right at the baseline of the table, half long. Again, Shuxin can scrape off the back like nobody's business. It's just slightly tighter. Liam Pitchford's serve gets him the point. 8 points apiece.
Let 8-all.
If I'm Liam Pitchford, I'm thinking same exact thing as 14-13 in game number 5 at the timeout. Perfectly played, the touch game. Trust yourself in the touch game. I mean, that sage advice that he got on that timeout. For every point, if he can keep that with him, Shuxin's gonna have to do, well, what Shuxin often does. Pull out some magic. Just shock the world with what he can do. More central on the table here, Shuxin. Oh, the bendy inside out forehand from way down low behind the table. That was such a tough point to play. Shuxin does everything right here. Spinny backhand, hooking forehand into the body. Last shot doesn't miss by a lot. The fortune that Liam Pitchford had in the start of this match, if that ball comes down and catches the back edge, he's got 2 match points. But Shuxin saves and fights to tie it up. What combination, the Chiquita into the backhand side and wide out to the forehand. It is not over yet. The amount of focus it takes from Liam Pitchford here, the timing out in front to play that ball. Match point on his serve pitch.